हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर सेकेंड पोएम फ्रॉम योर बुक फर्स्ट फ्लाइट एंड द टाइटल ऑफ द पोएम इज फायर एंड आइस रिटन बाय रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट. सो लेट अस बिगिन विद द इंट्रोडक्शन फर्स्ट. रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट पोएम फायर एंड आइस एक्सप्रेसेस द प्रोफाउंड आइडिया दैट द वर्ल्ड वुड एंड इन आइदर ऑफ टू वेज, आइदर बाय आइस और बाय फायर. बोथ द कॉम्पोनेंट्स आर कंपेयर्ड विद सेल्फ डिस्ट्रक्टिंग ह्यूमन इमोशंस, हेट्रेड एंड desire. The poem very artistically underpins the philosophy that we let our emotions rule us, and if don't control them, they will surely destroy everything around us. Similarly, he thinks fire and ice both are just as competent in bringing the world to a catastrophic end. Now let us begin our poem. Some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. From what I have tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. So in the first stanza, desire, it means a strong feeling of wanting to have something or wishing for something to happen. Favor, it means approval or support. So in the first stanza, the poem expresses the profound idea that the world would end in either of two ways, either by ice or by fire. One group is of the opinion that someday the earth's core will get so heated up that it would lead to fire destroying the earth's surface. On the other hand, the second group says that if the temperature goes down to an extent that makes life on earth impossible, it would have the same catastrophic effect. The poet then compares fire and ice with the destructive features of human emotions, desire and hatred. He says that from what he is aware about fire's desires, he would favor the ones who say that it would be fire. By saying so, he brings about the idea that human beings let their emotions rule them, and the consequences of unmonitored longing is chaos. Now, the second stanza. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction, ice is also great and would suffice. In this stanza, perish, it means die, and suffice, it means be sufficient. So in this stanza, then by not waving off the first option of fire, he considers if the world has to expire twice, to destruct twice, ice would be equally competent in ending it. He brings about a contrast between ice and hatred. The human capability of insensitivity and hatred has the potential for inner destruction. Though slow and steady, it has the same effect that desire has on us. So, if given an option between fire and ice, ice would be just as good as fire to destroy the world. So, in this poem, Robert Frost used a symbolic poem where fire is used as the emotion of desire and ice that of hatred. So, in this poem, fire stands for desire and I stands for hatred. It is a symbolic poem. Poet used the idea of two groups who have their own possible explanation for the end of the world. One is of the opinion that fire alone can destroy each and every possibility of life on earth, while the other thinks that if ice as a result of extreme low temperature could cover the earth's surface, it would lead to the end of the world. Both the components are compared with self-destructing human emotions, desire and hatred. The poet is originally of the opinion that he has been very closely associated with the fiery desires and considers it capable of bringing human beings on the verge of destruction. Thus, he considers fire as more component for destruction, but then he thinks that icy hatred is just as capable of ruining humans, though slowly and steadily. Therefore, if earth was to end twice, ice could be just as good as fire. If fire would lead to rapid destruction, ice would lead to silent damage. Similarly, if fire is pure passion, ice is pure reason. Thus, the poem very artistically underpins the philosophy that we let our emotions rule us, and if don't control them, they will surely bring us all on the verge of chaos. So, according to the Robert Frost, fire stands for greed, conflict, cruelty, lust, and ice stands for insensitivity, coldness, intolerance, indifference, rigidity, and hatred. So, with this, our second poem, Fire and Ice by Robert Frost, is completed over here. Thank you.